we're down on the banks of the Willamette River. Over the last couple of days, we had quite a bit of rain and flooding that went on in the Portland area. So the stage of the river is quite high, and it backs up into the mouth of the Tryon Creek here. We have a lot of wood that has been placed here as part of the rehabilitation project. What's the importance of all the wood that we've been seeing in the area?
You know, the Pacific Northwest is characterized by ancient forests with giant logs, and when these things would blow down into a stream, they could take hundreds of years of being in that stream for macroinvertebrates to attach onto and, you know, just fish to hide underneath. And as those logs moved through the system, they also got hung up on riverbanks like this one here. So as we've been logging out our beautiful old growth forests, we've just really lost that habitat element. And so what we do is we just try to restore those pieces and give the fish a place to hide out. We really like to use the root wads that you see here because they're all messy and a fish could dart in there and hide out, and a bigger fish might not be able to get in there after them.
With the Tryon Creek too, it's a side channel of the Willamette, and so it also had some fish passage issues. What were some of the problems with that?
One of the problems with fish passage was at lower flows, the culvert under the highway, just about 1,000 feet up, would become perched and water would spill down, making it difficult for fish to get into. And so one of the things we did in the early phase of the project was to raise the channel bed up about 2 feet, and so that the fish could at least access that culvert during those conditions.
The mouth area really important for a lot of fish species that are characteristic of the large rivers here too. What are some of those species?
Yeah, I think so. On a number of the tributaries, Tryon included, that come in. So you mentioned that the heavy rains have created some backwater, and actually the tidal cycle from the ocean, it can be influenced all the way up to here
huh?
as well. And so there are a number of listed species that pass this area in the Willamette. There are coho salmon, there are steelhead, there are chinook. There are Pacific lamprey, which are not listed under the Endangered Species Act, but we know adults pass here, as well as juvenile and larval forms rear here. Western brook lamprey is also rear in the main stem. And so all of those species use the mouths of the tributaries, including potentially this area of Tryon, for some rearing opportunity.